tomorrow. Katlego Monareng was shot after violence broke out at the Soshanguve North campus in August. For more on this, we're joined by Katlego Makgobole, the outgoing president of the Student Representative Council. At last, some progress.
Yes, we can't say we have found closure, but all we can say is that we are a step towards finding closure, because you know that you are a suspect until you are proven guilty by a court of law. So we will only find closure if the court of law rules that the police officials that are implicated in this case are actually going to be sent to jail, and the keys of their cell are going to be thrown in the sea. Because these police officials did not only rob us, our revolutionary, they also killed a third-year student who was about to complete his qualification and go home to enhance the general welfare of his family and the society at large. Because we're at the residential area of Comrade Katlego. The situation there is bad. The situation of the community is also bad. So these police officials have robbed us a diamond that was meant to shine.
Now, the two officers, of course, are appearing in court tomorrow. Are you planning anything?
It goes without saying, Vuyo, that we will mobilize support from our own students to go and show support for our late Comrade Katlego, because we are actually disturbed by two facts here. The Soshanguve police station issued out a statement the day after the incident that they are not anyhow involved in what has happened, meaning that they said that they are not responsible for the shooting of Comrade Katlego. The university followed suit and issued out a statement that there is no police official who used a live ammunition to actually disperse the students. So first of all, we are going to hold the university accountable for misleading the public. We are also going to hold the police station accountable for also misleading the public. But that will happen after the two officials have appeared to court. So tomorrow we're going to wake up early in the morning. We're going to meet. In fact, when we leave here, we're going to meet with our comrades to ensure that we strategize for tomorrow and see how we go to court to actually support the spirit of the late Comrade Katlego.
Now, have you also made sure that students who may help in both the investigation and actually getting the culprits to pay for what they have done, have you made sure that those people who have information will in fact come forward and assist the court?
Yes, in fact, our students went an extra mile to actually ensure that this investigative process is actually concluded. Because you'd know that after the incident of the 23rd of August, wherein we lost one of our own, Comrade Katlego, there was a compulsive strike in the university, which led to the management taking a decision to close down the university. So when they have closed down the university, they called our students who were at home to come and form part of the investigative process. And our students went as far as Limpopo, KZN, and Eastern Cape to come and testify. So that on itself is adequate enough to show that our students really needed justice for Comrade Katlego. Our students really need what is best for the university and the student at large.
Now, with regards to preparations for exams and the catch-up following the 6 weeks that the campus was closed, have you managed to find one another with the administration in as far as how that program, the catch-up program that is, has to be constituted, as well as the exam dates?
Yes, we are the ones who suggested to management that they should extend or shift the exam date, which was scheduled to be the 27th of October, if I'm not mistaken. They've shifted it to the 3rd of December. And we have also spoke to our students, and they told us as the SRC that they are also ready to attend on weekends, to write tests on weekends, and also attend extra classes. So we managed to get along with management on that note. But one thing that we are not agreeing with the management of the university is that there are two gates in our university. the main entrance and the it's normally called small gate and the pedestrian entrance. So now we've got, because the university cannot accommodate all the students, there are students who are residing at location or off campus. So now they are forced, there are some students who are staying near the main gate. So the university has taken a decision to not allow our students to access the campus or exit the campus using the main gate, of which is problematic because the two gates are far apart from each other. So now our students are forced to go from this, from where they stay to the small gate, and that on itself is inconvenient. When our students are from shopping, they pass the main gate that is close to their own residences to go up to another gate that is very far. And that on itself is dangerous because we are considering the crime rate of Soshanguve. You know very well that President Zuma once announced TUT Soshanguve as one of the dangerous locations in the country. So our students might be subjected to various criminal activities while they are walking to that gate.
If I heard them correctly, what the administration was saying the last time they were trying to explain this, they said it was because they believe that a lot of the people who are causing chaos are actually students who are not registered and people who shouldn't be at that university.
That is a lie. That is a lie, because if they are speaking about the comrades who are suspended, all of the comrades who are suspended now were registered students, because you can't suspend someone who's not a student. If now we are going to suspend people who are not students, we might as well suspend you, because we are suspending everyone. The people who are suspended were registered students and they were about to complete their qualifications. And there at the gate, there is a section for the pedestrian for pedestrians to access and exit the campus. But that gate has been broken for a while. The management does not want to fix that gate, and it is a problem to us.
Okay, that's all going to leave it. Thanks very much for coming through. Outgoing SRC President Katlego Makgobole.